So, how many of you guys out there own credit cards? I'm guessing many of you do, and you've probably received a credit card statement recently. And like always, the interest rate is reported. It usually hovers around the rates of 20%, which is pretty much industry standard. And my question to you is, if we have a rate of 20%, does this mean that we're paying 20% of interest a year? And surprisingly, the answer is not always. And it has to do with the difference between the term APR and the term year. So APR is actually the standardized term that's reported on every credit card statement, and it stands for the annual percentage rate. And the annual percentage rate reflects the amount of simple interest that we owe. And the APR can be calculated as the percentage rate per period multiplied by the number of periods. So, for example, if we had a rate of 4% a month, of course we have 12 months, then our APR would be 48%. If we had a 1% rate each day, then we're going to have an APR rate of 365%. It's just simple multiplication. Now, the difference between these two terms, besides just the what they actually stand for, and year stands for effective annual rate, is that year actually reflects compounding or the amount of compound interest. So year can be calculated as the percentage or the rate, interest rate per period. And instead of multiplying it by the number of periods, it's going to be to the power of the number of periods. And that way we'll get an exponential rate because compound interest is exponential in nature. And now APR is what is always displayed on credit card statements. And where it gets kind of sticky is if we have interest on interest or compound interest, and then we're trying to calculate it as APR. If we have interest on interest and the APR is calculated, then it's actually going to understate the interest rate that we owe. And that's because it's calculated as simple interest when compound interest is definitely much more. And you'll see this in a second. So, quick example. This is a timeline, and let's say that we borrowed $1,000. And this is just an example of simple interest. So, if we had the APR rate of 20% and we're making interest payments monthly, then our interest rates would be 1.67% a month. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So we're going to be paying $16.70 of interest a month. If the APR was reported and it was 20%, then that would be an accurate depiction of the amount of interest that we owe. Now, if we have compound interest, it changes because if we have a timeline and let's say that interest is accrued on a daily basis, because for most credit cards it is, then we're going to take the APR, so 20%, divide it by 365 days, and that's going to give us a rate of 0.054 794%. And this can also be expressed as a decimal as 0.00054794. And we're going to have, of course, 365 periods. I'm not going to actually draw out 365, but you can assume that there are 365 hash marks. So the amount of interest that we would owe along with the principal, let's calculate this out. So, day one, we're going to have $1,000 and we're going to multiply it by 1.0005 4794. So I'm using the decimal and I'm adding a 1 because we need to pay back the principal of $1,000, but we also need to pay the interest. So the decimal represents the interest and the 1 represents the amount of principal that we owe back. So that would be the amount we owe after day 1. Day 2 would look something similar, but instead of just multiplying it once, we would do it twice. And to make it even simpler, we could actually rewrite these two as just 1.0054794 to the power of 2, because them multiplying themselves is just to the square. It's the same thing as to the square. And you could see it would be the same up until day 365. So the rate would actually be 1.0054794 if we wanted to find the effective annual rate. We would raise it to the power of 365, and this would give us an answer of 1.2213, or not percent, but what the 1.2213 stands for is we owe the $1,000 back, the principal amount, and the 2213 stands for 22.13% of annual interest on the effective annual rate term. So if we were to look at the APR in our contract, it would be stated as 22%, which is much less than the 22.13%. So we might be misled, and or actually it's 20%, I should say, not 22%. It was stated as 20%, which is less than the 22.13%. So even if the rate was stated as 20% as an APR figure, we would effectively be paying 22.13%. And that's if it includes compound interest. So APR can sometimes be misleading. And now, why would they state the APR? Well, of course, 20% is less than the 22.13, and it's more appealing to consumers. So it's essentially a way that allows lenders to hide the true rate if you're having interest compounded on your balance. And the last thing I want to leave for you guys is I'm just going to clear these few layers, and I want to throw up a chart that just gives you an idea of the APR. So the APRs are bolded. So an APR of 1%, if it was compounded semi-annually, it would be 1.003% effectively. If it was compounded on a daily, it would be 1.005%. And you see it makes a much more noticeable difference as the interest rises. So if it's 50% compounding semi-annually, we'll raise it to 56.25%, which is considerably different if you have a large amount outstanding or a balance outstanding. So I'll see you guys in the next tutorial when we talk about notes receivable. Make sure to like, share, and comment if you have any questions.